research area is software safety. And that means that when you have something like a car that has computers in it that are in charge of keeping people safe, not causing crashes, you have to get the software right. One of my current projects is looking at making sure that autonomous vehicles are safe. So these are systems that nobody's ever going to be in. For example, an unmanned truck that's doing deliveries. We have a project called ASTAA, Automated Stress Testing of Autonomy Architectures. And this is a way to systematically stress test software. Right now, the way people are testing self-driving cars is they're driving around city streets. And the really easy to find bugs, you're gonna find that way. A few thousand miles, you're gonna see stuff that happens every few miles. You're not gonna see stuff that happens every million miles. We have an automated tool that will stress test self-driving cars and other robotic systems to make them see things that they would never see just driving around for a few thousand miles. And we're hoping that that finds problems that no one else would have found that makes the vehicle safer. My research group has been doing robustness testing of this kind for almost 20 years. So this is a very mature technology, and we think it's ready to deploy out on a wide scale. I think it's going to be really important to improve the skills of the people writing embedded software, because these things are becoming more and more safety critical. And the existing workforce was never really trained in writing safety critical software. The world has changed out from under them. Now all of a sudden their software can kill people, and it's going to be really important to make sure that their skills are upgraded so they can deal with that. One of the things I've done over the last decade or so I've been doing design reviews is collected up the kind of mistakes that people tend to make, the kind of things they need to get better at. And there's been a couple products of that. One is that I wrote a book, which every chapter is a company who basically got it wrong. And that book has become pretty popular for engineers who are saying, oh, here's a technique we should use. The other thing is that it's informed my teaching. And so I've had these 150 design reviews where I've rolled that back into my teaching so that our graduates come out knowing how not to make those mistakes.